3, and it says, "Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard that went down to the skirts of his garments, as the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, even life forevermore." Church, I'm teaching from the life-changing message, blessed because of our unity. Blessed because of our unity. And my central thought is, there is a blessing that God will command for all of us if we are all on one accord. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. I would like to just break down, if we can keep up, Psalm 133. I'd like to just break down a few of the words. Behold. Behold in this scripture is as if he looked upon such a gathering, like our gathering here today, and he saw there the expressions of mutual love. So he said, behold. Isn't it wonderful if people come in and they see us and they see our mutual love, amen? And then it says, how good, then how prosperous it is, how proper it is, how suited to promote happiness and to diffuse good influences. Do y'all know what diffuse is? I have a diffuser because I love aromatherapy. And I put that diffuser on and those scents just go all over my house. So when people come in here, they smell and they see the diffusion of happiness, of good influence. Do you feel that when you walk in here? Does anybody feel that when you walk in here? I feel it. I feel it from you all. Amen? And then it says, to dwell, and that means to stay and abide. See, flightiness is not dwelling. Amen? Not understanding why you're dwelling someplace is not dwelling. You have to know why you're dwelling. You just kind of gotta get locked in, like just boom, like in the lowrider. Did you have a lowrider? Did you have a lowrider? No, he didn't have a little right. But when you click in, Derry probably had one. But when you click in, it's like, boom, that's what. Amen?
Amen.
So you're dwelling in that thing. We're dwelling here, amen?
Amen?
Like the precious ointment, the oil of joy. They're talking about an ointment that is anointed by the anointed man of God. But it has joy in it. Do you feel the joy? Do we have the joy?
Yes.
We got the joy down in our heart. Do we have the joy in us?
Amen.
When we walk in here, do we give all our problems, all our troubles, all our sorrows to God and let that anointed oil run over us and give us the joy that we need? We're in this world, y'all, but we're not of it. So we need that anointing when we walk in here. I'm going someplace with this, y'all. I'm going someplace. And then it says, for there the Lord commanded the blessing. He didn't recommend the blessing. He commanded the blessing. When God commands something, it's done. Amen? Can I get an amen? He appointed that as the place of worship here. What is here? What is Zion, y'all? The church. This is Zion now, today, since Jesus came. Amen? We are Zion. He has anointed this place of worship because it's his. as the seat of his residence. God is here, y'all. We have to know that when we come in here, God is here. He's already ready to meet us. We have to have that trust, that faith that when we walk in this door, we're just adding to what God wants to do today because we obeyed and we're here. And we obeyed him and we're in our seat and we're present. Amen? As the seat of his residence. Can you imagine that God is sitting somewhere? It could be right by Rebecca. He right there by you, girl, because he got something right on him. But he's with us all. You know that, right?
Yes.
He is with us all. The source of all holy influences. He is the rewarder. He rewards us for being here in Zion. Amen? Why? Because of unity. Because of unity. Do you want to be blessed? Do you want to be blessed? I do. Raise your hand if you want to be blessed.
Amen.
You know, pastor's always been teaching us about faith, hope, and love. Well, now, since we've been in Bible study, it's about faith, hope, love, and unity. Unity. Faith means what?
I got
you just said that, right? Faith is the belief and trust in the loyalty of God. The complete trust in God. Hope is the confidence, expectation of something good. Are you expecting something good?
Yes.
Are you expecting something good? Not just eternal life. We in this world, y'all. We got to have some goodness up in here.
Yes. Yes.
Help us, Lord.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but I'm tired of not receiving the blessings of the Lord. And why do we not? Because we're not in a position. All right? We're not holding fast in that faith. We keep sliding off. We're not adding to our faith. We just keep saying, I believe God said this, but I got a whole message about your butt. Gotta get the butt out the way. Get the moon out the way. And love. God is love. Strong affection for another arising out of kinship, our personal ties. We're kin, y'all. We're royalty. We're sisters and brothers. We're heirs, joint heirs. Amen?
Yes.
My children, our maternal children, mothers don't play about their children. And my son is here, my son to my sons. My daughter, I don't know where she is, but I got a grandbaby now. Ooh-wee, that's ooh. You know, my children kicked me to the curb, but that one, baby.
Amen.
And see, when that's the endearing love that God is looking for us to have when we walk in these doors, amen?
Amen.
When I heard the teaching that Pastor was giving on during Bible study, I started thinking back on when we first started the church. You know our anniversary is coming up. So I started thinking about from the clubhouse to the hotel to the park and then to the church. Somebody say from the clubhouse to the hotel.
To the park.
To the church. Right here. We have been some places, y'all. And in every place, we were excellent.
Yes.
We were excellent.
Yes.
I mean, the men were up there looking good. I mean, the men were, the women didn't have to do nothing. No. We were always trying to feed them and everything, right?
No.
Because we didn't have to do anything, say anything, right?
Right.
We were always bringing something. We always had more than enough at that clubhouse. At the hotel, we're supposed to bring stuff in. Snuck stuff in. Hey, we were paying enough. If the double tree is looking, sorry. But it's all right. They knew we did it. Because I told them, I said, we brought some donuts in today. You want one? Yeah, anyone. Amen. And then the park. We had more dinners in that park. We had more going on in that park.
Yes, we did.
We dressed up that park. Everybody brought something in that park. We had fundraisers in that park. I gained 10 pounds in that park. I'm still trying to get that park off. Had barbecues and carrying on every Sunday. We didn't want to go home. So now we're running out the door once we get in our church. Y'all know I'm gonna tell it. I got to tell it because I was like, do you remember the time? And you know I never look back. I don't like looking back. I like pressing toward the mark, but I had to look back for a minute because I was like, we were building something. We can't stop building because we're here in our own church. We have paid a price to be here. We have worked hard to be here. This is God's church, but you built it. He used you to build it. If we keep building it, they will come. They will come.
Amen.
It takes a lot of consideration. It takes considerable effort to dwell together in unity. It seems like since we got in here, we all going in different directions. I can't even catch nobody. After church, I'm in the parking lot. Hey, so-and-so, where you going? Girl, I got to go. You know, who's singing the song in preparation? I'm wearing that out. I'm wearing everybody out, the same people out. Had to give some people a break. We got some young folks in here who know how to work. Where my young people? Who? We need you to take over. Alicia, thank you for stepping up, baby. But we need people like Lottie. Come on, Timber. Come on back into the fold, baby. I see you back there. But we need you all. We need you all. Sister Kim has been working from the day one. And she needs some help, y'all.
Amen.
And some people just sit here and then they run right out the door as soon as church is over. We need you, amen?
Amen.
Remember, unity is the most difficult thing to achieve, but it's the greatest thing to achieve. Amen?
Amen.
Can we achieve it?
Amen.
In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 3, it says endeavoring. Now, Sister Karen, Minister Karen broke this down. Endeavoring means to strive. We gotta strive. Endeavoring, striving to keep the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. That means we gotta do something. We gotta move forward. Amen?
Amen.
Not when things are going well. Not just when things are going well. Right?
Right.
But when things aren't going well.
Amen.
Not when we don't have, when we have money. But when we don't have money, I don't hear no amen.
Amen.
Not just when we are well, but when we're not well.
Amen.
Not just when pastor is doing what we want him to do.
Well.
Right?
Amen.
But when he's not doing what we want him to do.
Amen.
And me for that purpose. Right?
Right.
Not just during those times, but all the time. Let me tell you what unity means. Unity, the quality or state of not being multiple. That means oneness, y'all. Then unity means a condition of harmony. That means accord, y'all. Then the quality or state of being made one. That means unification, y'all. So in Bible study, Pastor has been teaching us from Acts 16. We heard Karen break down that story. You know, and it says in Acts 16:9, it says, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. There stood a man of Macedonia and praying him, saying, come over into Macedonia and help us. And after he had seen the vision, immediately, it didn't say he endeavored. He said, immediately we endeavor. Can you say we?
We.
We endeavor to go into Macedonia. Assuredly gathering that the Lord had called us for to preach the gospel unto them. We endeavor, it says here. This is the first time that Luke referred to himself as being in the company with